In our previous class, we have studied about the poem Wind, and today we are starting chapter 2 of our Behind Dress book, and the name of the chapter is Sound of Music. This chapter is divided into two parts, and today we will study part 1, and the part 1 names Eveline Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. When we read, this is a very strange thing, now how it's possible a person who cannot hear the sound then also listens the sound of the music. It means it's not possible, but Eveline Glennie has made it possible. How? Because in her childhood, when she found that she is not able to hear any type of sound, it means she was a deaf, then she started to feel the sound of music by her body parts, and she made it possible that everything is possible if we can try. If we are trying, we can achieve anything. We can make ourselves a successful person, whether we are not a normal person then also. So in this chapter we will study about Eveline Glennie. Title is Eveline Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. God may have taken her hearing, but he has given her back something extraordinary. What we hear, she feels. So it means God has taken this ability of hearing from the Eveline Glennie, but he has given some extraordinary abilities to her. And which kind of abilities? The kind of abilities which she could feel far more deeply than any of us. We cannot listen the sound of the music by our body parts because we have already ears. But she had not, and she tried to listen this sound by her body parts. That is why she expresses music so beautifully. Read the following account of a person who fought against a physical disability and made her life a success story. Russia crowds Joseph for position on the underground train platform. Joseph means push roughly. In the starting, we are reading then when Eveline Glennie with her father, she is on the platform and they both were waiting for the train. So the people were pushing, they all knew the scene of the platform. There was a rush, a crowd of people, and they all are pushing each other. Russia crowds Joseph for position on the underground train platform. A slight girl, a thin girl, looking younger than her 17 years, was nervous and yet excited as she felt the vibrations of the approaching train. And she was very excited. The girl in which we are talking, that is Eveline Glennie. That time she was very excited. Why? Because she was also able to the sound of the train. Why? Because the vibrations. She was listening the sound of the train by the vibrations as the train was approaching on the platform. It was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London. And actually she belongs to the Scotland. And she was moving to the London because she was joining this Royal Academy because she wanted to learn this music. Music in London and daunting enough. Daunting means frightening. Daunting enough for any teenager fresh from a Scottish farm. Already I told you she belongs to Scotland, so the author has used this Scottish word. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was profoundly deaf. She was completely deaf. Aspiring musician is a person who wants to be a musician. See, this was a very strange thing, a person who had this desire to be a musician, whether she had not this ability of hearing, she could not hear by this ears, but then also she had this desire, she wants to be a famous musician, and at the end she became also a famous musician. Eveline Glennie's loss of hearing had been great though. Her mother remembers noticing something was wrong when the 8-year-old Eveline was waiting to play the piano. And when her mother understood that Eveline was not able to hear, when Eveline Glennie was 8 years old, that time her mother noticed in her childhood she was interested to play this musical instrument, so she was playing the piano. At the same time, when her mother was calling her name again and again, but she was not responding. Why? By this incident, her mother noticed that there is a problem in hearing. For quite a while, Abigail managed to conceal her growing, but again and again she concealed. Conceal is hide. That time, Abigail was hiding this disability in front of her family members or in front of her teacher. can achieve our goal. And there was a cartoonist, that name is Ron Forbes. So she visited United Kingdom. She had decided to make music her life. She auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of the Academy. And in this Royal Academy, she got highest marks in the musical history in the Royal Academy. She gradually moved from orchestral work to solo performances. Orchestral work means group performance. When we are playing all this musical instrument in a group, it means there are many players with us. And after this, she started to solo performance or solo performance when she was only performing in front of the audience. At the end of her 3-year course, she had achieved most of the top awards, and after that she got many awards. And for all these, Eveline won't accept any hint of heroic achievement. But then also, when she achieved lots of rewards, lots of prizes, but then also she was humble. Heroic achievement means she was always very humble. She was not egoist girl. When a person became successful, actually suddenly he became egoist person also. We also don't know sometimes when we have done something strange and we got success, suddenly we started to show in front of the normal person that we are different from him. But she was not like girl like that. She was behaving in front of all the people that she is just like normal girl. She was a very humble, she was a very kind-hearted girl. If you work hard, and what she was saying to the others, if you work hard, know where you are going. It means the first thing, if you are work hard, the first condition, we should work hard. Second thing, what we should do. We should know about what we should do. You will get there. And if you know your position and place, you can achieve anything. And she got right up to the top. And the world's most sought after multi-percussionist with the mastery of some thousand instruments. It means at the end she learned to play something thousand musical instruments and hectic international chef. It is intriguing to watch Eveline function so effortlessly without hearing. Intriguing means fascinating. Fascinating or curious or things attract. And there was a attraction in the normal person's body, Eveline really, because she was a completely deaf person. Then also she became a famous musician. In our 2-hour discussion, she never missed a word. Man with bushy beards give me trouble. She laughed. It is not just watching the lips, it's the whole face, especially the eyes. She speaks flawlessly with a Scottish lilt. Lilt means a way of speaking. The way of her speaking, it was very natural. I could hear till I was 11. Then she saying, my speech is clear. She was saying that my speech is very clear because I could hear till I was 11. Till 11, she was not completely deaf. She could hear some sound. But after 11 years, she became completely deaf. She says, but that doesn't explain how she managed to learn French and master basic Japanese. And after that, also when she was completely deaf, then also she learned other languages also like French and Japanese. As for music, she explains, it pours in through every part of my body. She is saying, in my whole part of the body, there is a music and only music. Because she wants to be a musician, a famous musician. It tingles in the skin. It means she was saying, by my skin also I can listen. I can listen the sound of music. Because in my whole body, there is a music and music. My cheekbones, even in my hair, it means by her hairs also, she started to listen this musical sound. When she plays the xylophone, she can sense the sound passing up the stick into her fingertips. By leaning against the drums, she can feel the resonances flowing into her body. Resonances means the echoes of sound. On a wooden platform, she removes her shoe and working. It means there was nothing impossible for the villain Glenn, and she made it possible also that there is not any other possible thing if in our life. Only the two things are there, where we are going and what we have to do. We should know about these things. I have just gone to work, often harder than classical musicians, but the rewards are enormous. Enormous means the rewards were huge, the rewards were big. Apart from the regular concerts, Villai also gives free concerts in prisons and hospitals. After that, she performed without any other charges in hospitals also, because in hospitals, we know, there were many patients. There are many patients. And she performed in front of the patient also in the hospital without any other charges. Not only in the hospitals, but in prisons also. Evelyn also gives free concerts in prisons and hospitals. She also gives high priority to classes for young musicians. And Richling of the Beethoven Fund for Deaf Children says, she is a shining inspiration for deaf children. They see that there is a now where they cannot go. And she is the inspiration for these deaf children, because they also can understand. If Evelyn can do, we can also can do. Evelyn Glennie has already accomplished more than most people twice her age. It means she almost achieved in one life, and a person cannot achieve in just double time. She has brought percussion to the front of the orchestra and demonstrated that it can be very moving. She has given inspiration to those who are handicapped, and she is a great inspiration, a person, those who are handicapped, because she had also disability of hearing, and she became the famous successful musician in this world. So she is a great inspiration for all the handicapped people who look to her and say, if she can do it, I can also. And not the least, she has given enormous pleasure to millions, and she has given a huge performances, not only for performances, a great performance she performed in the audience of this whole world. So with this, the chapter is completed. These word meanings you have to write, not only these, the word meanings.